हेलो फ्रेंड्स, सो वेलकम टू आवर ऑनलाइन चैनल. माई सेल्फ चेतन जाधव. सो टुडे विल स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 1, इंट्रोडक्शन टू कैड कैम सी. सो व्हाट इज मीन बाय कैड कैम एंड सी? जस्ट विल सी द लॉन्ग फॉर्म. कैड इज नथिंग बट कंप्यूटर एडेड डिज़ाइन, कैम कंप्यूटर एडेड मैन्युफैक्चरिंग एंड सी कंप्यूटर एडेड इंजीनियरिंग. सो बेसिकली कैड इट इज़ द यूज़ ऑफ द कंप्यूटर मेथड्स टू डेवलप ज्योमेट्रिक मॉडलिंग ऑफ प्रोडक्ट इन 3D फॉर्म सच दैट ज्योमेट्रिक एज वेल एज मैन्युफैक्चरिंग रिक्वायरमेंट्स कैन बी एग्जामाइंड. सो बाई यूजिंग दिस कैड वी आर गोइंग टू क्रिएट सम ज्योमेट्रिक मॉडलिंग ऑफ द पार्ट ड्रॉइंग इन 2D 3D फॉर्म एंड एज वेल एज we are going to use this CAD system at the time of the manufacturing requirements. CAM, it is the use of the computer methods to develop computer numerical part programs for machining and other manufacturing process. So by using CAM system, we are going to create some CNC, ENC part programming for that particular part manufacturing for the machining purpose. And other manufacturing process, that time we are going to use various CAM softwares. So this is the basic use of the CAM. Next, CAE, it is the use of the computer methods where we are going to solving that modeling into the analysis so that we will get some results. Whatever we are going to applying the pre-processing and post-processing, that time we will get some results from that modeling part. So that purpose we are doing this using this CAE. In that CAE, basically we are going to just analyze that model. Okay. So this is our first chapter, just short introduction. What is a CAD, CAM, and CAE. So this is syllabus for this first chapter, that is a product cycle and CAD CAM CAE. Advantages, disadvantages, then hardware. What are the hardware used in CAD-CAM CE? Then list of the input and output devices. Then functions of graphics software. What are the functions the graphics card operated? Selection of the CAD-CAM CE software. How we are going to select the different software for the different purposes. So there are some committee, there are some theories we will see at this time. So we will start our first syllabus. So we'll start from the definition of the CAD-CAM CE. So overall, what is mean by CAD-CAM CE? So it is a technology where we are going to use by using these computers to perform the certain functions at time of the design and manufacturing. So this is the overview definition of the CAD-CAM CE. Here we are going to using advanced computer to produce to perform various functions at the time of the design and manufacturing. So a CAD is nothing but a creation and modification of the design. CAM is nothing but to plan, manage various process plans, control the various operations by using CAM software through direct or indirect computer interface. Here you can take the example of the NC part program. Okay, so here we have to process plan for the various operations. Next, CAE, it is nothing but a software computer to simulate the performance order to improve the product designs, and this includes simulation, validation of the results, optimization of the products, processes and manufacturing tools. So this is the definition of the CAD-CAM and CAE. Next, product design concept. How we are doing to develop the a concept of the product design concept. So in that product design, it is defined as a process to describe a machine or mechanical system to perform specific function effectively and efficiently by using scientific principles, technical informations and imagination of the designer. Okay. A designer uses principles of basic engineering sciences such as physics, mathematics, statics, dynamics, and heat and fluid flow. एग्जाम्पल न्यूटन्स लॉ ऑफ मोशंस, डी लैम्बर्ट्स प्रिंसिपल, बर्नौलीज प्रिंसिपल्स एंड कार्नोट साइकिल. सो इन दिस प्रोडक्ट डिजाइन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्क्राइब मशीन और मैकेनिकल सिस्टम विच इज परफॉर्म एक्चुअली स्पेसिफिक फंक्शन इफेक्टिवली बाई यूजिंग वेरियस इंजीनियरिंग टेक्निक्स एट द टाइम ऑफ द डेवलपिंग द न्यू प्रोडक्ट. दैट इज कॉल्ड एज प्रोडक्ट डिजाइन कंसेप्ट. देर आर सम टाइप्स ऑफ डिजाइन इज देयर इन दैट. फर्स्ट दैट इज अ न्यू डिजाइन. If the design is created from a scratch through the application of scientific principles, technical ability and creative thinking known as new design or creative design. You can take the example of the locomotives, aeroplane, steam engine when they had come in first time for use. So basically new design means we are going to start it from it scratch through the application of the various engineering technologies. Okay, so this is the first type of the design, that is the new design. Second, adaptive design. There is some modification in current design which will give better results than the earlier design. This is called as adaptive design. Example, a press to be used. So adaptive design means whatever that first design is there in existing design, in that we are going to do the modification and that will be give the better results in earlier design. So that is called as adaptive design. The second, third, empirical design. In empirical design, various dimensions are set as a proportion of certain main dimension. That called as empirical design. Example, various dimensions of rigid coupling are given as a proportion of shaft diameter. In this design, we are going to give some proportional diameter to the one certain fixed or standard dimension, that called as empirical design. In that example, rigid coupling, we are going to give proportional diameter to the dimension to the shaft diameter. So that will be relatively perform with each other. So this is called as empirical design. The next, rational design. It is a purely a mathematical design based on principles of engineering mechanics or simply of engineering science. It called as rational design. It is totally depend on the mathematical design or principle of the engineering mechanics and simply engineering sciences. Example, design of the shaft diameter for coupling. So this is called as a rational design. So this is a concept regarding the a product design. You can see in that CAD section, geometrical modeling, that is the first step where we are going to creating the providing the information of that product regarding the geometrical size, shape, material properties. Then we are going to create engineering analysis by using CAE. Then design and evaluation step. After the drafting is there, so from this CAD section we are going to give us a 3D model part, and that will be going through the passes through the this flow chart. That is the first we have to do some first recognition of the need in the market. We have to take the survey. From that survey we have to collect the some statement, problem statement from that customer or market. Then we have to define the first problem definition, and from that definition we have to do some analyze, and from that we have to take the some synthesis. Then we have to do some analysis. Whatever given statement, problem statement, from that we have to overcome that problem and we have to create the new product. Then analysis and optimization, then evaluation, and then presentation. This cycle will continue, and this is called as a product design concept, and we have to up to date with the market every step by step. So that will be give more beneficial for the consumer also and owner also. So this is the main concept regarding the product design. Next part is a product cycle. So you can see here there is a some different stages is there in product cycle. So in that you can see first, that is a product concept. whatever idea coming through your minds, rough idea, we can call it as a rough sketch, that will be converted into design engineering. By using the CAD software, we are going to drafting. Then we are going to process the plan for the further manufacturing processes. Then we are going to order the equipment and tooling for that same part. Then we have to do some production schedule. Then we are going to actual production, that is manufacturing. The next part is the inspection and quality control department. And we are going to launching that part product into the market, to the customer and actual market. Like this cycle is continue, and this cycle is called as a product cycle. So we'll see the next first point of our syllabus, that is the product cycle and CAD/CAM CAE. So now you can see the previous product cycle and this product cycle with CAD/CAM CAE. There are some differences. By using our CAD/CAM and CAE system, we are going to develop the products with more effective. In this product cycle is driven by the customer and the market, which is demand the product. In this product cycle, actually customer is demanding, we want this type of the product in the market. So from that demand, we are going to produce this product. So the product cycle begins with concept for a product. Okay, after the making the product concept, this concept converted into 3D model and made the analysis, defined and translated into the plant for the product through the design engineering and CAE process. The plan is documented by drafting, by set of engineering drawing showing how the product is made. A process planning is formulated which specified the sequence of production operation required to make the product. New equipments and tools must sometimes required to produce the new product. Scheduling provides a plan that commit the company to the manufacture of the certain quantity of the product by the certain dates. Once all these plans are formulated, the product goes into production with quality testing, and again it starts with the customer satisfaction, feedback and market survey. So now we can see here, we are starting from the product concept. After that, we have to go for the 3D modeling by CAD software, design engineering, then drafting, process planning. This is our previous product cycle, but we are using this product cycle with the CAD/CAM CAE. So first of all, we have to start this product cycle by using customer and market survey. So by using this CAD, that is computer aided design, we are going to convert that just conceptual idea into the actual 3D model. After that, we are going to make some process plan and documentation by using the computer automated drafting and documentation from that modeling. Again, we are going to create some process planning by using the computer aided process planning in the CAM. And again, we have to go into order the new equipment tooling for that particular operation. And we have to do the production planning. Again, by using the computerized scheduling, material requirement, MRP, shop floor control. By using this, we are going to make the master production scheduling, then material requirement planning, then shop floor control planning. And after that, we are going to transfer that all the process plan to the actual manufacturing, that is a production. By using the various computer control robots, CNC, VNC, DNC machines. And after that, we are going to transfer that actual product to the quality and inspection control department by using computer aided quality control. And again, we are going to launch that product into the market and customer. Again, we are going to take some surveys and reviews from the customer. Again, we are going to modify that some flaws and errors in that product, and again we are going to repeat these cycles. So this is the cycle with CAD/CAM CAE, product cycle with CAE. So in previous slide we have seen that the just basic product cycle, and this side we have seen that product cycle with CAD-CAM CAE. So product cycle with CAD-CAM CAE will give some more benefits. So we'll see advantages of the CAD-CAM CAE. Design have more standardization. By using this various CAD-CAM CAE system, we'll get some standardization. CAD is faster and accurate method of designing components of products. So designing the product by using various computer packages CAD, it will be faster and it will be give more accurate result of the components. CAD helps to reduce the engineering personnel requirements. It improves the accuracy of design. A component can be easily drafted after designing because of its associativity. It is easy to draw the component on this CAD, on drafted, easily drafted after the once designed the part. Several design and manufacturing factors can be considered simultaneously and thus can be designed concurrently. In this CAD system, we can just integrate the different activities simultaneously, so this can be design will be more appropriate. Improved engineering productivity, we will get more productivity by using this CAD system. Better designs provided by using this computer aided design system. Fewer errors in NC part programming, so error will be reduced in NC part programming. Assistance in inspection of complicated parts, CAD will be provided some assistant in the time of the inspection at the complex part, so that will be easier for the inspection control department. Provides operational results on the status of the work in progress. That system will provide the work in process status. Save materials and machining by optimization algorithm. So we can reduce the material and machining time by using some optimization algorithms. Customer modification are easier to make. Afterwards, we will get some feedback and reviews from the market and customer. So it will be easy for the modification. Provides better functional analysis to reduce prototype testing. Reduce training time for the routine drafting task and NC part programming. For making program, doing programming and making drafting, the task will be reduced by this CAD system. Assistance in preparation of the documentation, it will also provide some task for the people. It will be difficult task of creating documentation, so CAD itself will provide some assistance for the preparing the documentation. It is also most important advantages of the CAD-CAM CAE. So we'll see next point, that is the disadvantages of the CAD-CAM CAE. That is, first, the software and equipment are very expensive. That is a major disadvantages. That any advanced technology we have to purchase, so it will be go for the higher cost. Need to train the staff for operating that machine, so we need some trained person, so staff. That is also disadvantages. Unemployment due to the use CNC and CNC machines, so we are using automation machinery, so it will be tends towards the unemployment. So these are the some disadvantages of the CAD-CAM CAE system. So now you can see, this is one of the example of the software companies and the product name, and here the we are going to using this various softwares. So first, that is AutoCAD and Mechanical Desktop, 3ds Max, Autodesk Inventor. So the company for this, the Autodesk, and they are just using for 2D drafting, 3D modeling purposes. We are using this AutoCAD software, Autodesk Inventor, Mechanical Desktop for computer aided design purposes. Okay, next, Dassault system, which is provided CATIA, Cosmos, SolidWorks, Abacus, Innova Smart Team for CAD designing purpose, analysis purpose in the application of the aerospace automotive industry, shipbuilding, and other industries. Next, Delcam. In that power shape, we are going to be using the software for the designing purpose in the plastic and packages. Next, that is Parametric Technology Corporation. So in that, they are providing pro engineers, pro mechanica, pro manufacturing, windshield for manufacturing purpose, designing purpose, analyzing purpose, and life management purpose in the application of the aerospace, defense, automotive, airlines. And last, that is Siemens. They are going to provide NX Nastra and SolidEdge ideas team center for the all three purposes: design, manufacturing, analysis, and life cycle management in the same aerospace automotive industries. So these are the some of the example where we can use this CAD/CAM CAE software. So some application is there. So for that, we are going to manufacture the different parts in different sectors by using this CAD/CAM CAE concept. So next point is functions of graphics softwares or functions of the design workstation. So this is the just one of the important part of the CAD/CAM CAE in the computer system. So first is that is the generation of graphics elements. In that we are going to create, or we can going to create, generate the element in the graphic system. In that consist of the certain basic shapes, likewise 2D point, line, circle, ellipse, parabola, and hyperbola. And in 3D shape like sphere, cylinder, cone, etc., we are going to generate the element shape by using these various commands. So second, the transformations. In the transformations are used to change the model on the display screen and reposition on it database. Suppose we want to change size or shape of this geometry or reposition of the database, so we can use this transformation command. The changes in orientation, size, and shape are done with the help of the transformation. Like first translation, we can translate this geometry. Then rotate the geometry. Scaling, we can increase or decrease the size of the geometry. Mirror, we can just create the one more copy like the same. And last one, the shear. So by using this transformation, we can just modify it, or we can call as reposition of the that geometry. Next, display control and windowing function. By using these functions, provide the user with the ability to view model from any desired angle and desired magnification. So by using this command, we can view the model from any desired size, side, angle, and magnification. Windowing functions provide the user with the facility to choose coordinate system and define boundary for picture and height. Okay, by using windowing, you can just choose any coordinate system, that is a local or global, and define the boundary for that geometry. Next, segmentation and editing. So in that, the functions provide with user with the capability of selectively editing, replacing, or modifying the some portion of the geometry or given model. From this command, segmenting and editing, we can easily edit, replace, modify the some portion of the given model. And last one, that is user input function. So in that, the interface between users and systems through the various input devices should be user friendly and graphical in nature. Whatever that we are going to provide user interface between system and user, in that input devices, that should be user friendly and graphical in nature. The software should provide the flexibility of customization, where the user can create his own program as per his requirement. So whatever software is there, that should be provide some flexibility in between users and system. Here we want to customize some tools. We can create the some own program for the requirement, given requirement. So that is the some functions of the graphics software. So remaining part we will see in next lecture. Thank you so much.
Hopefully you might have enjoyed the lecture. Then please do like the video and know your thoughts in comments. Please do share this video among your friends and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. After subscription, you can press the bell icon to never miss the notification regarding our new videos. Thank you so much.